Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome back. I think we have full house in the agency. Yeah. Do any of you love to watch or read fiction? Raise your hand. One. Oh my God. Almost everyone except Tamika and Kavya. Everyone loves fiction. Why? Tell me why. Yeah. Exciting, okay.
It's fun.
Fun. Different story than the reality. Okay, it's, yeah, actually, yeah, it's different. That's why we like it, right? It's actually, we are looking for something mysterious. You know that? What is mysterious?
Something that's
mystery. Mystery, what is mystery?
Something you don't know.
Something you don't know. Something is there. Something really wonderful is that I don't know, then that's mystery. You really want to see it, right? When actually we are looking for fiction, we are looking for actually something mysterious. Shall I tell you a secret? Actually, our life is full of mysteries. I'll tell you why I said it, okay? For example, okay, Lokraj. Do you know why you are born to your parents? Out of 5 billion people on this planet, why you chose those two parents? Does anybody know? Any of you?
Because
yeah.
They look alike.
now you look like, because after you are born. Because you are born, then you look like. It's a mystery. And you know, your body has 3 to 4 trillion cells, and every cell is working some completely amazing things every moment. Do you know that? Is that not a mystery? Something mysterious is happening inside our body, and everything in our life is a mystery. Yeah. People are always, actually, the sad thing is, we didn't know anything. We think we know, okay, every day you see the same mother, same father, same mother, same father, and you think you know everything. Actually, it's your memory, it's not mystery anymore. Right? That's why when you see small children, their eyes are like this. They see everything as mysterious. Right or wrong? Because there is no memory for them. But slowly we develop memory for us. Everything is normal, boring, nothing. So we want fiction. But in reality, the real thing, the real life is more mysterious than the fiction. You just need to have the eyes. Even, okay, just like people, numbers are also like people. Now today, we will see some mysteries of rationality. Okay, that is the topic for today. First I have to tell you what is it. Okay, what is the rational number? Before I, oh yeah, you know that? Okay, what is the rational number?
Negative or positive fraction.
Okay, yeah, he said rational number is it? That has a fraction. Okay, simply put, okay, we already discussed a little bit last time, okay? So numbers, you can say whole numbers and decimal numbers. You know that? Whole number is like a whole pizza. Have you ever eaten a whole pizza?
Yes.
This is a whole pizza. Okay, this is how many whole pizzas are there? One. This is called a whole number. One. And this is another whole pizza. Two holes. And suddenly somebody had a sibling, unfortunately. So now this is a whole pizza? Not anymore. It's a maybe half. It's a half. Okay. Then things start, then the game starts, when there is sibling, right? Okay. So this is a whole pizza. The numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, undivided numbers, they are called the whole numbers. Numbers that are divided, split into fractions, okay? They are called decimal numbers. Okay, this is a 1. What do you call this? Half. Half, you can write? Oh, half, right? Or you can say, do we call it as? 0.5. This number like a 0.5. We call it as a decimal number because it has got a decimal point, okay, we know that. And in decimal number, there are two types. Okay, one is called rational and other is called irrational. Rational means that which you can represent like a fraction. You know what is a fraction? Fraction means it's a division of two digits. Okay, the upper one is called a numerator, N. The below one is called a denominator, D. Okay, anything that can, any decimal number that can be represented as a fraction, they are called rational numbers. Okay, today we are going to see the secrets of rational numbers. Next class or maybe the after, we will enter the world of irrational numbers. Okay, but for today, we'll only focus on rational numbers. First, we'll simply start with the simple thing that we already know. Okay, so this is a rational number. You know what is this? How much is 1 by 3? Okay, who will say no? I don't want to ask these two guys. Okay, yeah.
0.3333.
Okay, is it right?
Yeah.
The answer is 0.333. How many threes? Forever we have to write, no? Infinite threes are there. You know this? Yeah? This is called a recurring decimal. Recurring means that? Recurs, that keeps coming. That's called a recurring decimal.
What about 1 by 5?
1 by 5 is a... What, how much is a 1 by 5? Who can tell? What is 1 by 5? Oh yeah, you. Yeah, 0.2. Hey, give claps. Be generous with your claps, okay? Yeah, it's free. So 1 by 5 is 2. Is it a recurring decimal? No, right? This is not a recurring decimal. This is a recurring decimal. Hey, actually, in your homework today, okay, there is a table. Okay, it's like, it goes like this. It has numbers from 1 to 9, 1 to 9. Okay, this is a numerator, this is a denominator, and you have like this. Okay, so you have to fill these funny things. But why, what should you fill here? Sorry, here's a 1. This is more dirty. Yeah, here 1 by 1 is a 1. You can say 1 or 1.0, doesn't matter, it's a whole number. Okay, and what about here? 1 by 2. What is 1 by 2? 0.5, you have to fill. 2, 3. What is here? This is 2 by 1. 2 by 1 is a?
0.5.
2 by 1 is 0.5? It's 2. Okay. So you have to fill. Okay. Once you fill, you know everything about decimal numbers. Almost everything. Okay. Because I still have to tell something. Okay. So this is one homework for you. This is easy.
What do we have to write for
1 by 3? 1 by 3. Good question. That's why I love you. So 1 by 3 is this, right? This one is, this is, yeah, he wants to know, if I start writing infinity, I have to write till end of my life. That's what you want to say. Okay, what do we say here is, well, we put a dot. We just only write 1, 3 and put a dot. Okay? Hey, some people put a bar also in some textbooks. But we use bar for some other purpose, right? So that's why we put a bar. All my childhood, I was intrigued by one decimal number. That is actually 1 by 7. Can anybody tell me what is 1 by 7? I only want to work this one in the class. You can do the remaining things by yourself. Okay, we'll start dividing. We'll start dividing the normal way that we are taught in the schools. Okay, you want to try this way? You want to try this way? Okay, so 0.1. Okay, next. You put a 0. Then it's a 4, then 2, it's a 2, 8, 5, 7, and then again 1 started wrong. 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7 will, this part will repeat. Forever. It's not that the recurring digit, there will be only one digit. There can be any number of digits that could recur. How many digits are recurring here? We'll come back to this later, but remember, how many digits here? Maybe I'll write this for you here somewhere. 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, okay, 0 point. Okay, we'll come back to this later. Now, in this case, how do you write here? You put a dot here and here to just indicate that this digit, from this digit to this digit, it will keep recurring. Okay, this is how you do your homework. And now we will enter what I actually wanted to say. So this is something, okay, now this is something the founder of Vedic mathematics or the rediscoverer of Vedic mathematics, his name is Bharati Krishna, used to teach people all around the world in various universities. Okay, today that we are going to learn. Okay, the example is, suppose there is a number 1 by 90. Okay, what is the answer?
Decimal
is, yeah, it's the same, right? Okay, rational number is
ratio.
Not, already it's a ratio. Okay, it's a ratio. Ratio is a fraction. You know why you call rational number as a rational number? Because it can be represented as a ratio like this. Okay, now the answer is going to be a rational number. Rational number, okay? I will give you one more hint. This is going to recur. It's a recurring decimal. Okay, what is that? Usually how we do, either you have to divide with the 19th table, 19 ones or 19, you have to do that. Right? That is one way. Or you can use the crowning gem. Or you know our crowning gem, right? You have to set it up in a crowning gem. And then it's like a 1. You can put lots of zeros here. And then what is the divisor here? 1. And then plug is a? When the plug is bigger than the divisor, it becomes a little difficult. So, yeah, we have to change it to a 2 bar 1. So, 19 as we can be represented as a 20 minus 1 that we call actually as a 2 bar 1 and then start doing. Okay, this is something else we have to do. But now, these kind of problems, you don't need to even set up. You just simply can write the answer down. Okay, we'll see how. Okay, ready? What is the ekadhika for 19? 2. 2 is the ekadhika for 19. Okay, she doesn't know what is ekadhika. Ekadhika means nothing. If the number is ending with a 9, okay, whatever is the previous digit, plus 1 is called ekadhika. Okay, this number is a 9. Before 9, what is it? Here, the digit before here is 1. 1 plus 1? 2, that's it. What we do is, we simply divide 1 with a 2. That's all. And then we will do something trick. Ready? Be with me, okay, completely. Now, okay, is this number, okay, 1 is less than 19, so we have to put a 0 point and we start dividing 1 with 2. How many 2's are there in 1? 0. Remainder is a 1. Remainder. The only thing is that 1, we put it here, before the answer we put the remainder and make it a 10 and start dividing with 2. 10 divided by 2? 5. Remainder? 0. Okay, 5 divided by 2? 2. Remainder? All of you say? 1. Now this number is a? So all of you say, what is this number? 12. Okay, 12 divided by 2?
6.
Remainder? What is this number? 6. Okay, 6 divided by 2?
3.
And then?
Remainder
is 0. What is this number now? 3. 3 divided by 2?
1.
1. Remainder?
1.
1. Next? 11 divided by 2?
5.
5. Remainder?
1.
1. 15 divided by 2?
7.
Remainder?
1.
Okay, is that right?
8.
Okay, then what? 8. Remainder? 1. Okay. Yeah, next we'll go to the next line. Okay. Yeah, start. 9 4 1 7 0 3 1 6 1 6 1 8 0 0 4 0 0 All of you.
1, 6, 0.
And then again we reached at 1. Again we started at 1, right? This is, and then now this is done. Again we reached at 1. First we started dividing a 1 with 2. Now again we reach a 1. So that is going to, that's it. This is the, so how many numbers are, how many digits are going to recur?
18.
Yeah, how many?
18.
18. From here to here. That's the answer. Did you do any calculation here? So much. Did you do actual division? But the answer is there. Done. Now. These are the, okay, you forget about these small things, okay? But these big digits, okay, these are the answer. Yeah.
Can we only do this if the numerator is
1? No. Anything. Okay, we'll see. Okay, we will try 11 by 19 next, okay? Yeah.
We're seeing because of thing ended in 1. But then in the middle of the calculation, let's say there's another 1. So why can't it turn 10?
Yeah, okay, but this is actually 11.
But you said that you should not, like, we don't need to look at the...
She's right, actually. Okay. It's not because here it is 1. Actually, it's because it's a total is... The number you are going to divide is 1. Thank you. This is, here it was 11, right? Still, it's not 1. Okay, you understood? Actually, you know how this procedure came? This came from this only. Okay, in crowning gem division, how do you do? There are three steps. Divide, multiply, subtract. But if there is a bar here, divide, multiply, add. Okay. So you go and check it out yourself. The same thing that we are, this is a shortcut for this procedure.
So we just divided
with, we are only dividing with 2.
So we only divided with the,
this multiplication with 1 is nothing, we don't need to do. Remainder whatever it is there, you have to add. That adding we are actually doing, putting the prefixes here. Okay?
So
we
just have to multiply and divide with each.
That's all. Yeah. So now there are 3 secrets in this answer. I want you to find 3 mysteries. These mysteries nobody on the planet could find out till Bharati Krishna found. In this answer, there are 3 mysteries. Not you. Not those who watched the video. Okay, first you. There are 3 ones. Where are 3 ones? 1, 2, 3, 4. These ones? Now. Hey, claps! Claps, Agastya! See this? If you add these 2 numbers, how much is the answer? Wherever you are, there, wherever you go, if you add the vertical these things, it is adding up to 9. That means what? That means what? If you know half the answer, remaining half, you don't need to calculate, it comes, you just subtract, you write up to here, and then you subtract from 9, 9 minus 0, 9, 9 minus 5, 4, 9 minus 2, 9 minus 6, 9 minus 3, 9 minus 1, done. If you just write down the answer, the half will come without calculating. That is the first miracle or mystery. Second one.
No, I have a question.
Yeah, okay.
How do we know when it's half?
How do you know when it's half? That's the second mystery, actually. That's the second mystery, yeah.
Like after we finish it 8, then whenever it starts to become 9,
it starts. No, the thing is, when you reach halfway stage, what is the number here, total number here?
9.
What is the number here?
18.
This one, right? This 18 is nothing but 19 minus 1. If you reach somewhere 19 minus 1, you know that you have arrived halfway, and the remaining answer you simply put it down. Yeah, that is the second mystery.
Yeah.
Then, yeah.
The third mystery is that everyone, 10 plus 9, 5 plus 4,
everything. Yeah, he found something, some other mystery. Yeah, this is 10 plus 9 is a 19, 5 plus 14 is a 19, 12 plus 7 is a 19, 6 plus 13 is a, oh my god, you found fourth mystery. I didn't know that. Okay, there is actually a third mystery. I was waiting. How? The symbol. How many digits are there in the answer? Not yet.
No, 18. No, I didn't watch the video.
Okay, how many number? Okay, yes, sir, yes, say.
The denominator, the number in the bottom, which is 19, minus 1 is the number of digits which is in the answer.
Yeah.
Behind.
Okay, give 50% claps. Because I still doubt that she might have watched the video. Okay, so 19, the denominator minus 1 is 18. Thus, that many digits will recur. Right?
So for any fraction, will it always add up to
9? Any fraction, yeah, this one.
Yeah.
Okay, let us, okay, he asked 2-3 questions, let us see. Okay, next, let's try 11 by 19 and see if everything holds good or not. What is Ekadika? Still a 2. We'll start dividing. Okay, first you have to put a 0 point or not? Because this number is smaller than this. You're ready, you're all with me? All of you, say it loudly together with me. Okay, the first answer. 11 divided by 2.
5.
You have to say 5 remainder 1. Say it out.
5 remainder 1.
Next.
7 remainder 1.
9 remainder 0. 4 remainder 0. 7 remainder 2. 3 remainder 1. Hey, how do we know we have reached halfway or not?
9 by 2.
When we reach 19 minus 11, that is 8. When we reach a 0, 8. Okay? Okay, yes, go ahead.
8 remainder 0.
We have arrived. Okay. So, we have arrived. Yeah, that's it. The answer is, that's it. That's the answer. You got it. Claps to everyone. So, remaining half we can simply write. How do you write? You don't need to calculate the remaining half. What is the answer here?
4.
Because you just have to subtract these things from 9. 4, 2,
1, 0, 5, 2, 6, 3.
Yeah, you can see, if you still divide 8 with 2, you get a 4 remainder 0, right? Now you see, adding these things add up to 9. You got it? So this rule holds good for anything, yeah.
You said it should be, what do you call it? 11 minus 19, so there are 9 digits in the first time itself.
Yeah. So 19 minus 11, we use it as the number, you know, to identify we have reached, arrived at the halfway stage. 19 minus 1 is, denominator minus 1 is the number of digits that will recur at most. Sometimes that many numbers may not be there. Sometimes that number may not be there.
You said in the 1 by 91, you minus the denominator by the numerator and then you get the amount of digits that are there in the answer.
No, denominator minus 1.
Minus 1.
That's all. Suppose the denominator is 49. Then how many digits will recur at most? 48 digits. Okay, any other mysteries you found? Hey, you see, yeah, there is a mystery actually. There is another mystery by looking at these two things. Okay, let me remove these small things. If you are okay. There is another mystery if you see. Okay. Yeah, Charanika got some mystery. Go ahead.
No, like all of them have the same digits.
Claps! Claps! This generation the claps. This is 100% claps. This answer and this answer have the same digits. 5, 2, 6, 3, 1, somewhere here. 5, 2, 6, 3, 1, come back. 5, 7, 8, 9, 4, 7, 5, 7, 8, 9, 4. Can you see? So check it out. Maybe you can try 11, 12. So why? Because the divisor is, when the divisor is same, this is something funny that is going to happen. Yeah, go ahead.
But what if it's 39?
39, yeah.
Wait, so what?
No, the divider is 39, yeah. Denominator is 39, then how many digits will recur? At most 38. Maybe it will be 19.
Is it like possible that you can do it the same way as we did?
Okay, let's try. Hey, before that, okay, before I come to your question, see this. these digits in the answer are same, when the denominator is same, the answer digits are also same. After you go home, you try, you know, you all remember the 9-point circle? Okay, there is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is a 9 or 0. You all remember the 9-point circle we learnt in maybe digits or somewhere? So, now you plot, you make a pattern, okay? You draw something. What is that with these answers? Okay, from 5, where are you starting with a 5? Where are you going from 5? 7, next? 8, 9, 4, 7, 3, 6, 8, 4, 2, 1, 0, 5, 2, 6, and that's it. 3 already there. So everything will have a beautiful pattern. Okay, even those, even this 1/7 thingy.
So you
forgot what? I had one. Oh yeah, from 6, 3, 1. Oh, 6, 3, and 1. Okay. So you try. Okay, you plot this on a 9-point circle and see. Hey, even this one, this is 1/7, right? You also check. Just check it out and tell, okay? You plot it on, you find different patterns, you will find different mysteries, new mysteries. Hey, come back and see if this one holds good or not. What? We have found something here. We have found something, already so many mysteries. Now come back to 1/7, this is also recurring from here to here. Oh yeah, I have to put a dot here and here. See this, 1/7 is 6 digits. 6 digits are recurring. Yeah.
If you write 857 under 142,
yeah,
it will add up to 9.
Yeah, 852 you put under 857, put them under 142. Vertically they add up to? And that's it. How many digits are recurring?
9.
How many digits are recurring?
6.
That 6 is?
7
minus 1. Maybe, I don't know. That is the thing. And anything else? Any mystery else? Okay, we'll keep it that. Okay, now you know, when Bharati Krishna went and taught these mysteries, people were like shocked. What? I have never seen all my life. That was the expression from everybody all around the world. Really, I want you to play with this and then come up with different mysteries. Okay, now the master keys are with us. Right? The master keys is now available. You just have to open. Everything, all the treasures are open for you. You just have to go and enjoy. Okay, we'll try something big. You are ready? 9/39. What is the Ekadika?
4.
Shall I put a 0 point here? Okay, 0 point. What is the answer? Start.
2.
First, yeah. 2 reminder. 1. Next. Hey, what is the halfway point? Halfway point is?
30.
39 minus 9 is? 30. Okay, max number of digits that will recur is? 39 minus 1, 38. Okay, we'll see how many. Okay. 30 is the halfway, okay? Okay, start. 4. Okay, 9 divided by 4. 2. Reminder 1. Next. 12 reminder by 12 divided by 4. 3 reminder. 0. Next. 3 divided by 4 is a 0 remainder. That's the halfway for you guys. And that's it. The answer is, now how many more digits are here?
3.
3 more. What are they?
7.
9 minus 2, 7. 9 minus 3, 6. 9 minus 0, 9. That is the answer for you.
Wait,
see how she is laughing. I love when somebody is laughing. Okay, hey, I told you, right? I think you were not there. Okay, whenever you make somebody laugh, you get a point. Okay? Yeah. And if somebody laughs at you,
minus.
No, you still get a point. You get a point. It doesn't matter if somebody's laughing because of you or laughing at you. It doesn't matter. You get a point. That's how the counts. Okay. This is done. Okay? Okay. Now we'll come to...
No, you said there's maximum 38 digits, right?
Maximum. It need not be every time.
Minimum is 7.
This is done. It's already done.
One,
over. Yeah.
Seven.
Yeah, what he said is that this number is actually same as 3 divided by 30. Okay. No. So 3 by 13, the number is not ending with a 9. See, whenever the numbers are big and close to tens or hundreds, the things are very easy to handle, right? That's why 19 is very easy. Usually in the normal mathematics, 99, big number. But for us, they are like the most funny things. You all remember the base division, base multiplication method? Okay, so, yeah, when there is a number ending with a 13 here, the divisor, what you have to do? You have to make it, somehow you make it end with 9. Then what you have to do? Multiply the denominator and numerator with
3.
This is ending with 39, now this is easy. Okay, you can do this way. Okay, suppose there is a number 7 divided by 13. How to do this? How to do this? Multiply the numerator and divide it by denominator by 3 and then make it a, this is a 21 and this is a 39. Ekadika is 4 and then start dividing 0 point and then go on. Okay, okay, this is that thing. I think you know, there's nothing to tell. Okay. 7 by
17.
Okay, 7 by 17. What is to be done now? This has somehow you have to make sure that it ends with a 9.
You can't subtract or add. Only multiply
by. No, basically, if the denominator is ending with a 9, things become easy.
By any operation, right?
No, it has to be equal. The problem.
So
you have to make sure the problem is same. Okay, if you change the problem, then your mark, you won't get the marks, okay?
As in 2 plus 7 and 17 plus 2.
Okay, so if you add 2 here, it's like this.
The answers
are different. If you have changed the question.
I get lots of points.
No, he gets more points. You will not get points. Your parents will be called to the school.
Because everyone's laughing, he gets more points.
Okay, he's right. He got lots of points. Okay, we're about 20. Clap. Very good. 717. Okay, you have to make it somehow. You have to make it such that it ends with a 9. What is to be done?
49 plus 1 9.
7. Just see this digit. With what number if you multiply it will be with the 9, you have to multiply with 7. So this number is a 17 times 7 is
119.
What about then you have to also multiply with it there? 49. And then Ekadika is 11 plus 1. 12 is dividing that. Yeah, we'll come.
You keep count of how many points you got?
Me? No, I lost track.
And what if the numerator is bigger than the denominator?
Oh, okay, which grade you are in?
7th.
Okay. So we'll see. Okay, give me one number where the numerator is bigger than denominator.
9 by 5.
Hey, maybe I'll allow one number. Let me use my favorite number.
No!
Oh, this one is yes. So hard.
What is this?
3.14.
Different one. Nobody likes this number.
3.14.
Hey, you know, see, you know, you don't like a person because you don't know him.
Yeah.
Okay. Now today you will know this number and you'll start liking it. That's my promise.
So we know all the whole pi.
That's already pi.
No, this is now that is a misunderstanding. This is not pi. Guys, this is not pi.
Yeah.
This is a close approximation to pi. Okay, pi is a number that is called a, okay, that is used in geometry, right? That is used in geometry. So that number is also infinity number, but it doesn't recur. Okay, it doesn't recur. Those numbers are called irrational numbers. For example, square root of 2 that's not a recurring decimal. It's a decimal, but it's irrational. Okay, we'll talk about this in next class. Yeah, this is not a pi, guys. Okay, now you can, the first thing, now you know better. This is not a pi. See, I was not the one who hit you last night. Please, trust me, it's like that. Okay, so 32 by 7, okay, we'll see the answer. Hey, yeah, this one even, actually I got confused and how to find the halfway?
Negative?
I didn't understand, so I asked my teacher, Dr. Ken William, sir, this one, how to find the halfway? Then he said, first, you make it
3 over 7.
Hey, I forgot. I asked him again, I forgot.
3 over 7.
So, yeah, it's actually 3, yeah. Oh my God. You are as good as my master. 3, this is 3 1 by?
7.
You are right, man. This is 3 1 by 7. Okay, there are 3 holes and a fraction, right? So 1 by 7 can be represented as? Change to ekadika. What is to be done?
7
by 49. Okay, 49 minus 7 is a 42. When you reach 42, you know you are halfway. That was his head. Wow, claps to my hip. I forgot and he got it. Oh my gosh. Anyway, now when you reach a 42, we start calculating. Okay, when you reach a 42, you know you are halfway. Okay, we have to multiply this one with 7 and this one with?
Seven.
Okay, so okay, we have to change when this one too? So this is a 49. What is this? 154. Ekadika is? 5. Start dividing with the ekadika. Then? Start dividing. Okay. 154 with a 5. 3. Point.
3.8.
Okay.
3.8.
Yeah, okay, yeah, here, yeah, okay, here what you have to do is 3 is this thing, 0, and then wow, we have to, 5, 3 is 15, okay, remainder is a 3, and then you have to divide 3, right? Now, actually, there is one more number here. This poor guy is still remaining, no? Right? So you have to add this guy to here, and then divide. Okay, so 4 plus 3 is 7, okay, 7 divided by 5, 7 divided by 5, 1 remainder. 2, okay, then 21 divided by 5, 4 remainder, again divide, 2 remainder, 4. Hey, 42! It's already 42, done, it's over! Now you.
Same as 1 last.
Yeah, yeah. It's just 3 and 1 by 7.
And it's just 7 there.
Yeah,
so when the answer reaches 42, it's done! How many more digits are here?
3.
3, what are they?
8, 5, 7,
and you put it a dot here. Hey, and then what he found? This answer is here. Because the divisor is a 7, it doesn't matter what the numerator is. The only these 6 digits will come in the answer. It may rotate. Oh. That's it. Now, do you still hate 22 by 7?
Yes.
You still hate? Yes. You want to make us laugh?
No.
You still hate 22 by 7?
Yes.
Okay, it's good to hate sometimes. Okay.
So, if it was minus 7 by 22 or minus 22 by 7?
Just put a minus in the answer. Yeah.
First,
find out
how many holes there are in the
number
and then you put it and then like add the decimal, like since the 3 and 1 7,
can you
write 3 and then what's 1?
Class! Just class! She's right! No, even I didn't tell this actually. Even I got it wrong. After he gave the hint, she picked it up. So 22 by 7 is 3, 1 by 7. This is nothing but 3 plus 1 by 7. Just do the 1 by 7 thingy here.
It's
3. And then this 3 here and then this string here. That's it. Oh. Mystery, claps to everyone. Now we have learned, even I learned so much in this class. Seemingly difficult things also we can simply do by this. Suppose there is a number 1.23 divided by 19. I think we already did a half of it, almost 90% of this previously. Yeah.
You have to multiply 4000 by 100.
You have to multiply? No need. No need, it's already there. Whenever there is a denominator ending with a 9, it's like a breeze. Ekadikati, you start dividing. This number is smaller than this? This number is smaller than this? So we put a 0.6. Okay, start. First, start dividing with a 2. 1 divided by 2 here, right? Because we have to go 1 digit at a time this way, in this way. Okay, just be careful. Okay, just go 1 digit at a time. 1 divided by 2. 1 divided by 2 is a 0 remainder. Okay, then this number is a 10. Before dividing, this poor digit is still there. Add it and divide. Okay, 10 plus 2 is 12. 12 divided by 2. 6 remainder 0. Now before, still any digits remaining? One more digit remaining, no? Okay, 6 plus 3. 9. Okay, 9 divided by 2. 4 remainder 1. Anything else?
No.
Nothing, you just go on. 7 remainder 0. That's all. That's the only thing. Okay. Any number divided by this you can do. Okay, so one thing, sometimes what happens is there will be a carry. Okay, that thing is not actually needed for you, just I wanted to tell you how to handle. Suppose there is a number 72.7 divided by 29. Okay, yeah, what is the Ekadika?
3.
We start dividing. Okay, with 3.
7.
First,
two remainder 1.
First is okay, with the 7 divided by 3 is 2 remainder 1. Yeah, that's there. Okay, and then yeah. Oh, this number you are dividing. Okay. Yeah, we put a point here. Okay, because yeah. Because yeah. Yeah, 12. This is a 12. Shall we divide 12 with 3? 12 plus 2 is 14 divided by 3. 4 remainder. Again, okay, this is a?
How come 72 is less than 3?
72 is actually, okay, you can see another way. 72 is less than 29 or more than 29? More than 29, that's why you don't get a 0 point, okay? There will be one digit at least before decimal point, okay? Okay, you're right. Okay, now, oh yeah, now the number is? Number to divide with 3 is a 24. Shall we divide 24?
No.
There is one more poor chap here. What is that? 7. Okay, total? 31 divided by 3. 10 remainder 1. Okay, then this is the only thing you have to be little bit careful. 10 remainder 1. This is a carry. Okay? This is a carry. This one will actually go and make this a 5. And this one will also go here and make this a 2. And this actually the number is a 20. That is the only thing remaining in this. Okay, now 20 divided by 3 is
6
remainder, and that's all. Okay, there is nothing else. So basically that is what I wanted to teach today. So somebody asked, what is that? What did you say? Yeah. So yeah, you said I remember your question. So he said, suppose if the denominator is not ending with a 9. Suppose it is ending with a 1. Suppose there is something like 19 divided by 31. You don't need to learn this, okay? Because why I said you don't need to learn this? Because 31 is easy to handle. This is easy to handle with crowning gem, right? You all remember crowning gem?
No.
With the flat. Okay. You didn't know crowning gem, right? Okay. We will tell you a video. You have to watch it and you will understand very easily. We have to change this problem into little bit differently. So subtract a 1 from here and here. Now we are coming to his realm of things. Okay. Subtract 1 here, 1 here. It becomes 18 divided by 30. Okay. It's like almost like 1.8 divided by 3. Okay, now we start dividing. This is a 0. 0.6. Remainder is there? Okay, 0 here. What we have to do is, we subtract this number from 9 and subtract. 9 minus 6? 3. 3 divided by 3? 1. Shh. Welcome. Now subtract 1 from 9. 8 divided by 3. And also, and this is one way. There are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of ways here actually. That's why I don't want to tell all those terms. Yeah, no, but this is this. Okay, yeah, this is 9 minus 2?
7.
Yeah, this is 27 divided by 3. That's how it goes. 9, yeah. So, the purpose of everything that I am telling you here is numbers have certain characteristics, just like people. If you know those characteristics, they become your friends. You may remember all these formula, all these ways, or you may not remember. You may forget everything. But still, you will not be afraid of this number. Right or wrong? Right? If somebody is your friend, you lost touch with him for 10 years. After 10 years, you are seeing the close friends for the first time. How do you feel? You start your friendship from again? From zero?
No.
Wow! Serenika, how are you?
That's not maybe recognize
him. Huh? Maybe space is completely different. Maybe he has mustache. Okay, or maybe he has tonsured. It's okay, but still, that love is still there, right? So, okay. Yeah, somebody asked why it is coming, right? All things about divisibility about division are coming from Karaninja. Okay, well, I can explain you after the class. Basically, everything is coming from Karaninja. All these shortcuts are from Karaninja. For example, this is for parents. Suppose there is a them. Yeah.
Is there a number like that? Like we keep using 9. Why is that?
Because.
Is it like even like we use the ekadika, we need to have 9 at the end, and then we need to have 9 for other things also. Why?
This one we actually okay. There is a beauty in the number 9. Okay, this one will not be probably there in the video. Okay, suppose 10 divided by 9 is
1.
1 remainder?
1.
20 divided by 9? 2 remainder? 50 remainder 9? 50 divided by 9. Do you see some pattern?
Yes.
The answer and the remainder will be same for if we are dividing with the 9 as the question. Say, for example, there is a number 123 divided by 9 you are doing, okay? But the answer is, okay, in Vedic way how we do this is, the answer is, simply the answer comes like this, 1. And then 1 plus 2? 3. Reminder, 3 plus 3? 6, that's it.
What?
Okay, so 9 is the beauty. Okay? Today, I have so many questions. That's so lovely. Okay, there. Actually, I wanted to tell this to parents. Okay. For example, if there is a number ending with 8, not 9. Okay, how do we do this? We can still start with the same way. Okay. So start, what is the, okay, so, we can, what is the ekadika if we 2 are 29? 3, we start dividing, okay, there is a 0 point, okay, we start dividing 9 with a 3 remainder 0. What we do is we double 3 and start dividing. Because this 8 is how much away from 10? 2 away from 10. That's why actually we have to multiply this with a 2. 3 times 2? 6. 6 divided by 3? 2, remainder 0. Again, double this. 4. 4 remainder, 4 divided by 3 is? Okay, so even here, okay, only double this one,
Only this one.
This is 12. 12 remainder 3, 4 remainder 0. Yeah, that's how it goes. So, because why this is coming is, again, from the crowning jump. 28, suppose if you are setting up the crowning jump here, 28, you write it as 3 bar 2. You divide and then multiply with a 2 and then add. So it's a, this is coming from Browning chart. Yeah?
But you can also make 28
and
you can also find the ekadika of
28,
right?
28, by there is no ekadika, it's a even number, right?
But you said by splitting it into 2, right? No, but splitting
that
into
becomes
2 into 14.
No,
seven
it becomes
four.
7 into 4.
7 into 4, yeah, well, maybe you are, then actually what you have to do is, first you have to divide this with 4, get something, again then you have to divide with 7 and then use ekadika way.
Yeah.
That is one. Okay, anything? Any other questions? Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.